Okay, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Okay. So let us continue our areas. What's the last question we discussed? Can you remember? Do you remember?
43
complete. Okay. Okay, 45. The area bounded by this and the ordinates -1 and 1. Okay. X mod X graph will be like this. When X is positive, X square. When X is negative, minus X square. This is Y equal to X square. This is Y equal to minus X square. They want between -1 to 1. So between -1 to 0, X axis above, curve is below. Whereas between 0 to 1, curve is above and x-axis is below. So obviously I have to break. Or I can say by symmetry, both are equal. Anyway, it's fine. Okay, so I can write -1 to 0, not minus x square. I should write -(-x)² dx. And 0 to 1, area under the curve x square dx. One which is above x axis as it is, below x axis you take negative of that. Okay, but actually both are same. You can even write 2 times 0 to 1 x square dx also. x³/3 with 0 to 1, which is 2. So here upper curve is x axis, lower curve is curve, and here upper curve is a curve and lower curve is x axis. Just try the next question. Okay, 47. You have to draw the curve and understand which region they are asking, first of all.
Okay.
X y square equal to a square into a minus x. Y square equal to a square into a minus x by x. How to understand the graph of this? First of all, this is LHS is positive, so RHS should be positive. Y square is greater than or equal to zero. That implies a square into a minus x by x should be greater than or equal to zero. So when I take number line, and I think I should take a greater than zero. They already mentioned there. Okay. So you take zero and e. Anything more than a, this is negative. This is positive. The whole thing is negative, positive, negative. So greater than or equal to zero only when x belongs to open zero to closed a. So x belongs to zero open, a closed, because denominator cannot be zero. So first of all, x cannot be anything outside this. Next, when x is zero, this value will be very close to infinity, and when x is a, it is zero. In fact, you can also write if you want a by x minus one. Okay, the graph of this at a it is zero, and at zero it is infinity, and it's a decreasing function. You can see as x increases, it decreases, and at zero it practically tends to infinity. So this is the graph. And if you replace y with minus y, no change here. And you replace y with minus y, no change means the graph is symmetrical about x-axis. So this. Whether this is a sharp change or very smooth, it doesn't matter in the area part. For that, I don't know at this point what is dy by dx. Is it zero or infinity or some other value? I have to differentiate and see for that. If I find 2y dy by dx, of course y coordinate is zero here. Okay, so it's not so important there. Okay, so now what is the question? This and y-axis. This is a curve, and y-axis means they want this total area. So only upper curve if I want. I can do right curve minus left curve, minus infinity to infinity. I can do that also. Right curve minus left curve, or I can do upper curve minus lower curve, or find this and double it. So either you can write y in terms of x or x in terms of y. If somebody writes y in terms of x for the upper one, it is a into root over a by x minus 1. For the lower one, minus a into root over a by x minus 1. Instead of that, if you want to write x in terms of y, I have to split it. Bring this side. I would have got x is equal to a cube by a square plus y square. A cube by a square plus y square. Just expand this. We'll get a cube minus a square x. Bring this on this side. Take x common. We'll get this. So if you want to do right minus left, I have to do minus infinity to infinity. So method one. Integral minus infinity to infinity a cube by a square plus y square dy. A cube into 1 by a square plus y square is 1 by a tan inverse y by a. This is integral with the minus infinity to infinity. A cube by a is a square. When I put infinity, tan inverse infinity is pi by 2. When I put minus infinity, it is minus pi by 2. Total it is pi, which is pi x square. If I want to do upper minus lower method 2, I'll find only upper. This is 0, this is a. 2 times integral 0 to a into root over a by x minus 1 dx. Okay. Now I have to think of how to integrate this. I have to multiply the a minus x and a minus x. Or I have to take x as a sin square theta, something like that also can be done. Okay, please try to understand how did we get the graph. Then how we are done right curve minus left curve. If any doubt, I'll explain. Thank you. Okay, anybody any doubt either about the graph or how to write the integral?
So
once then
how we got the graph.
Okay. Basically graph y square is positive, so this should be positive. For it to be positive, x should be between 0 to a. If you take anything more than a, it will be negative. And if x is negative also, it will be negative. So it will be between 0 to a. And between 0 to a by x is decreasing. At 0 it is infinity, at a it is 1. It is decreasing from infinity to 1. But this total is becoming 0 at a. So some decreasing function. So whether you take this or square root of this same graph more or less. And then when you replace y with minus y, no change means the graph is symmetrical about x axis. So whatever is upper down also. Yes. Please think about both methods. If you need doubt, ask me. Okay, anybody needs more time? Shall I erase? Okay, it will be completed, right? Okay, 49. Let f of x be a non-negative continuous function such that area bounded by pi by 4 and something more than pi by 4. So some curve is there. This is pi by 4. This is beta. This area is given. That is integral pi by 4 to beta f of x dx is equal to beta sine beta plus pi by 4 cos beta plus root 2 beta. Instead of giving the function, they gave the integral. And this is true for all values of beta, not just for one value of beta. Okay. So in the place of beta, you can write anything. Anyway, beta is a variable. I can differentiate with respect to beta. So differentiate with respect to beta. You know how to differentiate a definite integral. In the place of x, this limit will come. So this is going to be f of beta. Here, product rule. Beta into derivative of sine beta is cos beta. Sine beta into derivative of beta is 1. Derivative of cos beta is minus sine beta plus root 2 into derivative of beta is 1. Okay, so this is f of beta. Can I simplify further? No. Now they simply want f of pi by 2. So wherever beta is there, simply we have to substitute pi by 2. So this will be 0, this will be 1, this will be minus 1, this will be root 2. So root 2 minus pi by 4. Plus 1 is also 1 plus root 2 minus pi by 4. Area bounded by the curve, I think this is a very straightforward question, it can be in the beginning also. Y is equal to a square by x, some decreasing function like 1 by x graph, 1 by x or a square by x, more or less same. They want between a and 4a. This is a, this is 4a, they want this area. This is a very easy question, they can be in the beginning of the side. So simply integral a to 4a, a square by x dx. 1 by x integral is log x with a to 4. A square into log 4a minus log a. Log a minus log b is log a by b. So log 4a by b, which is a log 4. 4 I can write 2 square. If you want, I can write 2 log 2 also. So nothing big, just drawing the graph and understanding the area. Seven x minus x square minus 6. If I take minus common, it is x square minus x minus 6. Minus of x minus 1 into, x minus 7 into x plus 1. Okay, this is plus 6. Okay.
Sir, minus 7x.
Okay. X minus 1 into x minus 6. Right? Okay, so I said x minus alpha and x minus beta is an upward parabola. If minus is the downward parabola, with at 1 it is 0, at 6 it is 0. So it's a vertical parabola passing through 1 comma 0, 6 comma 0, but downward. X axis is also there, so they just want this area. Simply integral 1 to 6 upper curve dx. That's it. Integral 1 to 6, 7x minus x square minus. This is 7x square by 2 minus x cube by 3 minus 6x from 1 to 6. You can simplify this. So when I put 6, it is 7 into 18. Okay. This I think 125 by 6 will come if we simplify. A matter of simplification, nothing more than that. Okay, after one or two questions, we have some inequality questions which are very regularly asked in mains. We'll see how to manage the inequalities. Just read next to 55 and try.
Sir, you are in mute, sir.
Y equal to 2x minus 1 is a straight line. Intercept minus 1 and x-intercept is 1 by 2. Okay. So it will be like this. The slope 2. Whereas fractional part of x is like this. Okay, so what is that they want? Fractional part of x, 2x minus 1 and x axis. Okay, so let us forget about y axis. Okay. You can draw a dotted line if you want. So x axis, this is a fractional part of x, this. So they want this small area. Okay, so now if you let us take that small area what we want separately, this is like this, fractional part of it. The other one is like this. If you see carefully, you have to find all these points. This point is 1 by 2 comma 0. 1 by 2. This is 0 comma 0. Fractional part of x and x are same between 0 to 1. So this is basically y equal to x. This is y equal to 2x minus 1. If I try to solve, I'll get x equal to 1. So at 1, this is 1. But so the graph is not right. Hmm. the line is exactly passing through this point. Okay, this is minus one, this is one. This is 0, 1. Okay, sorry, so the graph should be more perfect. So if you look at this region, we want only this. So only that region, if I mark, it will be like this. All are triangles, I don't use any integration. This is 0, this is 1/2, this is 1, this is 1, 1. This itself is a triangle, half into base and height, I can do it. Base is 1/2 and height is 1, that's it. So area is half into base is 1/2, height is 1. So simply 1/4. Okay, so you don't have to use integration. If you want, you can do, because we know this is y equal to x. Y equal to 2x minus 1. So we know upper curve, lower curve, right curve, left curve, but that's a simple triangle. We don't need integration. Okay, 55, everybody understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 57, let us see how is the graph. Okay, 57, before completing the question, first of all, only log x graph will be like this. This is a graph of y equal to log x. Log mod x, this is not defined for negative values, but log mod x is defined for negative, it is even function. So this is a graph of y equal to log mod x. And x is negative also to defend, but not in C. Only mod log x. Mod log x means the negative part will become upper part. So it will be like this. This will be like this. This is a graph of y equal to mod of log x. Mod of log mod x. The mod is not printed properly there. Y equal to mod of log mod x. For this, I have to apply mod, so that will go up. Okay, so they want us to draw all these four in one place and find the area bounded by them. I think some small correction may be required, which area they are asking. But anyway, we write this and even this. Okay, if I draw all four graphs, actually I don't need all four, these are sufficient, but if I draw all four, it is this one, and this one, and this one, and this one also. Okay. If you don't draw x-axis and y-axis, okay, only draw dotted lines, then you will see the area bounded by these curves is this area, this area, this area, and this area. So will you find all that? Just find this first quadrant area four times that. So area will be four times integral 0 to 1. What is this curve? This is log x only. But this is log x which is went up, so it is actually minus log x, because between 0 to 1 log x is negative, mod log x is minus, so that is this. So I should actually integrate minus log x here. You write only log x also, no problem, you'll get like this, you'll get negative, then you have to put a mod. So how are you integrating log x by parts? Into 1 we'll take, so you'll get a minus x log x minus minus x into 1 by x dx with the limits 0 to 1. Now somebody can have a doubt here. When you substitute 1, not so okay. When you substitute 0, what are you going to do it? So I'm going to write minus 4. I'll take minus outside. When I put 1, it is 1 log 1. When I put 0, log 0 is not defined. So what will you do? You have to apply a limit there. So you are supposed to write there, limit extends to 0 plus x log. Okay, I'm writing after this here. When you... not visible, so I'll write clearly. Okay, finally putting all these four, please understand, we want this area, this area, this area, this area. I'm finding this four times that. That's what I've done. But in the next step, when I put 1, I'll get minus 1 log 1. Plus x log x, I have to put 0, that I have to write limit extends to 0 plus x log x. And that whole thing is 4 times plus 1, so that integral is x with limit 0 to 1. Okay. So when I put 1, log 1 is 0, that is gone. X log x limit is also 0. We have seen how. You take x equal to 1 by t, you will get log t by t. Log infinity by infinity, log infinity is very small compared to infinity, and all that, that will be 0. You'll get minus 0 plus 0 for this 1 minus 0. So finally it is 4 units. So this is 1 unit, this is 1 unit, this is 1 unit, this is 1 unit. So 4 units. Okay, so anybody doubt about either any part of the graph or integration, or any part of the integration, please feel free to ask. Any part of the graph, if you have doubt, please ask. Okay, so first of all, we want integration. Okay, from here to here by parts, take into 1 minus log x as it is, and 1 integral is x.
minus that minus x will continue, derivative of log x is 1 by x. And then after that, when you put 1, it is 0. That is very easy. But when you put 0, log 0 is not defined. So what to do? Integration is always open interval. So at 0, dot not defined also not an issue. When x is tending to 0, that is from the right side because you are between 0 to 1. Between 0 to 1 means you are right side of 0. So for this, at 0, what is this value tending to is important. That's why limit x tends to 0 plus x log. Here x and x will cancel and you'll be left with 1. And for 1, integral is x with limit 0 to 1. And this one limit is 0 because you take x as 1 by t. You'll get limit t tends to infinity minus log t by t. Log infinity by infinity. Even though both are becoming infinity, the numerator is much smaller compared to the denominator. So that limit will be 0. So that's how this is 0, log 1 is 0, this limit is 0, this is 1. Anybody else has any doubt about graph or integration, how to write or anything, please ask. Maybe 58, 59, 60, all we can do in the class only, because so that we'll get a clarity on inequalities. Okay, so in 58, 59, 60, they will not give some 2-3 curves and ask area bounded by them. They'll give 2-3 inequalities. Each inequality is a region. You have to take intersection of all these regions. For example, in 58, y greater than or equal to 0. What is this y greater than or equal to 0? Is both first and second quadrant, this whole thing. Y equal to 0 is this, y greater than 0 is everything above that. So both first and second quadrant completely is y greater than equal to 0. X plus y greater than equal to 1. What is that? X plus y equal to 1 is this line. I'm sure first year straight lines you remember, L equal to 0 is a line. L greater than 0 is one side and L less than 0 is another side. L 1, 1 or something. So x plus y equal to 1 is this line with x intercept 1, y intercept 1. But x plus y is greater than 1 means if you substitute origin, not satisfying. So it is not the origin side, everything on the other side. So it is this. Everything above the line. What is first one? Y should be greater than or equal to x square minus 5x plus 4. If I take y equal to this, this is a parabola. If I take x minus 1 into x minus 4, it is a parabola with 1 comma 0 and 4 comma 0 like this. Okay. Now, I want it to be greater than this. Equal to 0, equal to means this. It should be greater than this means everything inside the parabola, all this region. Okay. So we have three inequalities. We will take intersection of all these. So let us put all of them together. This is that x plus y equal to 1 line. Here at 1 the slope is 1. But here for this at 1 the slope is 2x minus 5, which is minus 2x minus 5. At 1, it is minus 3. Slope is negative. Here slope is minus 1, slope is minus 3. It has much more slope. Okay. So the parabola. So the parabola is having more slope like this. Whereas this line will be somewhat like this. Okay, so this is 1 comma 0, this is 4 comma 0, this point where parabola is intersecting y-axis 0 comma 4, this is 0 comma 1. So what we want, everything above this line, everything right side of this and inside the parabola. They gave y less than equal to 0, sorry. I wrote this greater than 0. They gave y less than equal to 0. So it is all below x-axis. So anybody want to tell which region they want now? Intersection of all these things.
Down
curve. It should be above the line, below y-axis, but inside the parabola. Actually, this region, but not this small thing. This will not be there. So for that, it's important for me to know what is this point of intersection. So I have to solve the line and parabola also. So here y equal to 1 minus x. So let me equate 1 minus x from here to x square minus 5x plus 4. This is one line, this is one parabola. When I solve this, x square minus 4x plus 3 equal to 0. X minus 1 into x minus 3 equal to 0. Okay, I'll draw this once again, same thing. One, two, three, four. This is the middle. It has some value. At three, this value is minus 2. Okay. And here it is down below somewhere. Okay, this is a parabola. And the line is like this. Okay, this is 1, this is 4, this is straight below 3, but they're intersecting it. Above the line, inside the parabola, below y-axis. So what we want is this whole dish. In that, between 1 to 3, it is area under the line, a simple triangle. Between 3 to 4, it is a parabola and x-axis.
Okay. This point is 3, comma, minus 2. And you put x equal to 3, y is minus 2. Okay, so exact figure is this. This is a parabola, this is a line, this is the x-axis. We want below x-axis, above the line, and inside the parabola is this region. In that we want, okay. So in the previous cases, it was clear. They give two curves and they want bounded by them. But here all inequalities are regions. So take the intersection of all. So if you want area now, this is a triangle, so I will not use an integration. Base is 2 units and height is also 2 units. So half into 2 into 2. This one is integral 3 to 4. It is a parabola. So I have to take x square minus 5x plus 4, but below, so I have to take minus. So it will be minus of x square minus x plus 4 d. Area is equal to half into 2 into 2 plus integral d to 4 minus of x square minus 4. You simplify that, you will get. This answer is 2. This answer, whatever comes, minus x cubed by 3 plus 5x squared by 2 minus 4x with the limits 3 to 4. And somebody will simplify and tell me whether you are getting correct answer or not. I think only this integral is should come 7 by 6. Okay, so then it is 19 by 6. Okay. Okay, this simplification is not anything great. Anybody can do it. But I just wanted to do, not very important thing that I'm telling. This I can write x minus 1 into x minus 4, right? So just to calculation, I want to make simple. I took x minus 4 as t. And they change the limits so that the limits will come minus 1 to 0. And this will be t and this will be t plus 3. That integration and that simplification will be easier. Little bit, not so much. Okay, so main point is when inequalities are given, you have to understand each inequality separately and then take their intersection. So is everybody clear? 58?
Yes, sir.
Can I erase the whole thing? Or anybody still copying? Okay. So by Monday, try to complete all these even numbers. We'll discuss doubts on Monday. Okay, 59. We have x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0 together. I will write it. X greater than equal to 0 means everything this side. Y greater than equal to 0 is everything above x axis. So both put together is first quadrant. So basically, it is first quadrant. That is x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0. What about y square greater than equal to 2x? Y square equal to 2x is a parabola like this. Y square greater than equal to 2x is inside or outside? If I take this point, let's say minus 3 comma 0, it will satisfy. Yes, correct. So it is everything is outside the parabola, not inside. Because if I take a point 1 comma 0, it is not satisfying. It is not this region; it is outside. So this case. Okay, so all everything is outside the parabola. That is this y square greater than equal to 2x. What is the other one? X square plus y square is less than equal to 4x. I think it is a circle, inside region of circle. If you bring one side, you'll get x minus 2 whole square plus y square is less than or equal to 4. Or you can write minus 4 less than equal to 0. S equal to 0 is circle, S less than 0, S 11 is inside. So the circle is center 2 comma 0, radius 2. So passing through 0 comma 0 and 4 comma 0 is ends of diameter. It is this circle, this is 0 comma 0, this is 4 comma 0, everything is inside that. So one is first quadrant, one is inside this circle, one is outside this parabola. Now we also have to see where is this parabola and these are intersecting. When I put y square as 2x, I'll get x square equal to x, x equal to 0 or 2. So they're intersecting right here. So let us put all of them. Okay, so this is our circle. Parabola is exactly passing through this vertical ends of the diameter of that. And the parabola is little inside the circle like this. Okay, now what they want? Inside the circle, outside the parabola, but in first quadrant. So this small region. So only that. So if I want to magnify that, take only the quarter circle and only the parabola. Okay. This region they want. So what I can do? I can find quarter circle, which is pi r square by 4, minus remove this area. So area is equal to pi r square by 4. That is a quarter circle minus. This is under the parabola between 0 to 2. Integral 0 to 2. What is the parabola? Yeah, root 2x dx. That's it. Circle, I don't have to integrate already. What is the radius of the circle? 4, 2. R square is 4. So this is pi. This take root 2 outside. X power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. When I put 0, it is 0. When I put 2, it is 2 root 2 into 2, 4. 8 by 3 or something. 4 by 3 or something. 2 root 2 into 2 root 8 by 3. So pi minus 8 by 3 option D. Yes. Anybody any doubt about 59? Miscellaneous, all even numbers you have to do. 60 will complete, but other even numbers. And numerical questions, all of them you have to complete. So we'll try to complete 60 now so that it will be done. And the next class, I'll discuss your doubts. And then go to advanced material. After areas advanced material is over, I can come back and do definite integrals advanced material also. Anybody else, any doubt regarding 59? So in inequalities, how to deal? Generally, you take equality and understand what is the curve. Then for depending on inequality, understand it is this side of the region or this side of the region. One way to do that is take an example in that region, substitute it. If it satisfies that region, if it doesn't satisfy the other region. Then all the regions put together, which they are representing. For example, here outside the parabola, inside the circle, and within the first quadrant, that is this. So it's not necessary to take this. Everybody completed 59?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us do one thing then, only 60 is left. So you can, in the even numbers, you can try 60 also. Okay. Only 58 I completed. And all numerical questions, there are only 10 of them. So by Monday, try to complete areas, mains material fully. Okay. Because later on, you'll have IP work and advanced material also. So Monday, I'll clarify your doubts in the mains material and then start advanced material, even number, odd numbers. All right. Okay. Thank you. Let us end the class.
Sir, 1 second.
Ah, చెప్పండి మేడం.
ఆ అదే స్టూడెంట్స్ కి ఒక చిన్న అనౌన్స్మెంట్ సార్ అదే క్లాస్ కోసం.
లిసన్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యు విల్ హావ్ ఎన్ అనౌన్స్మెంట్ ప్లీజ్ లిసన్.
4 టు 5 కెమిస్ట్రీ డౌట్స్ క్లాస్ ఉంది స్టూడెంట్స్ ఈ రోజు. మేడం పాస్వర్డ్ పెట్టారు R7 గ్రూప్ లో చూడండి R5 అండ్ R7. 4 టు 5 డౌట్ సెక్షన్.
ఓకే ఎవరీబడి యు హావ్ కెమిస్ట్రీ డౌట్ సెషన్ లింక్ ఇస్ దేర్. Our KVPY class is there, 325 to 4. Okay, if somebody interested, they can come.